This is the course introduction to SQL Mastery from Zero to Superstar. So why learn SQL? Well, databases store all the world's information, and SQL is the standard way to talk to these databases. Almost any idea you can think of involves storing and retrieving data, and so every company on the planet has one or more databases which are vital to their operation, and knowing how to query them and talk to them gives you an advantage over people that don't. So who am I? My name is Will Bunker. Dave Kenning and I founded the largest dating site of the 90s. It eventually became Match.com. I had to teach myself from the ground up how to do everything involved in getting this business off the ground, a major portion of which was learning how to manage databases. We actually had one of the largest databases of the 90s with millions of profiles and a huge number of searches going at any time, and we were constantly working with the data, trying to improve the data flow. Now, what are databases? At the core level, it's a piece of software that allows you to store information and retrieve that information. Now, there are two main types. There are SQL databases, which is what this course is on, and then there's NoSQL. And NoSQL is an unstructured form of data that's useful if you're dealing with stuff that doesn't have the same structure every time you look at it. My brother and sister had a company and they used NoSQL for a lot of their unstructured information about the security settings because they varied so much across different pieces of software. Let's talk about the SQL database universe. And you can roughly break it down into commercial and non-commercial. And so commercial SQL databases, Microsoft and Oracle are the dominant players here. Oracle is one of the original companies that popularized mainstream databases back in the 80s and 90s. They're still going strong and they've got a lot of certifications and software in this place. The other big player is Microsoft SQL Server. And this is actually the software that we used when we were building our dating site, and it was driven by the fact that it was a lot cheaper, I think $5,000 versus $50,000 for Oracle. Plus, they gave a free copy to you for 90 days, and so we felt like, you know, we would either have figured it out in 90 days or be out of business. So we went with Microsoft SQL Server. Now, there's been a big change in that open source SQL databases have become very popular over the last 15 years. It started with MySQL. Then there's MariaDB, SQLite, PostgreSQL. Now, SQLite is a great open source database that gets used a lot when you're building your MVP or sometimes out launch, but it's simple, reliable, it uses SQL, you can install it on your laptop and run it. Another popular one is MySQL. Now, this came out back in the 2000s. Now, it's since been bought by Oracle. And so that caused a little bit of consternation, and people were worried that Oracle, you know, wouldn't continue to develop it. So they actually forked it, and now there's MariaDB, which is an open source project around a forked copy of MySQL, and it's now, you know, gone in its own direction and becoming very popular. And then that leads us to PostgreSQL. Now, this one was an alternative to MySQL that became a lot more popular after MySQL was bought by Oracle. And this is the one that we're going to be using today. We're going to do this work around a typical database called Northwind. Now, this was originally released by Microsoft when they were launching AccessDB, and it represents a company selling products from multiple suppliers to customers around the globe. Now, in this, all data is grouped into tables, and Northwind has 14 tables, which includes everything from customers to suppliers to products to categories, and we're going to get into how to relate all this data and pull information from it. Now, each table consists of multiple fields, one or more, and these fields are the structure that you give the data, and so you create a field for each piece of information that you want every record to have. And then every record comes back as a row in a table. And so you can see here I ran a query, and it's pulled back multiple records, each of which has information in each field. And that's the basic structure of data and databases. And next step, we're going to get into installation and show you how to get the software up and running on your system.